Welcome back to the Stick. Now for our second council election guest, we have with us Ian Fayman, who is sitting right here.
Lucky me.
And lucky you.
Lucky. Everybody's lucky to have you running in the council.
Thanks, Henry.
You are first-time candidate.
First time, yes. After being president of the AJAX Football Club, I felt it was something I could do for the community, and I think it was important for the community that someone with a bit of experience, and yes, this is my first go at being a councillor.
And you have had experience in business?
Well, I'd run a textile company for 30 years, and that employed 400 people. And so having had those sort of issues of dealing with people, dealing with problems, I've got the experience in dealing with the issues that the residents, the local residents, want at council. I think I'll make a very good councillor. And this would be, having been retired, this will be my 24/7, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, full-time job looking after the residents.
And you've been married for 7 years.
Very happily married to Yvonne. 4 wonderful adult children. I'm a very fortunate person. To be a councillor.
And you've actually got a law commerce degree.
I have a law commerce degree
out
of Melbourne University.
Stead.
And yeah. It gives me good experience in those sort of issues. Use the law degree and commerce degree in my business field and in dealing with issues of the day. And dealing with planning issues or dealing with any council issues, having some legal background, being able to look up things, understand the issues, yeah, I think I'll be okay.
Have you ever been to any council meetings?
I've been to 3 council meetings.
Right.
And I really enjoyed the process, and there is a process. Mm-hmm. I think our council meetings at Glen Eira should be streamed. They're not streamed. I think there should be more public access to them.
Do you want to give me the job to film it? Are you talking about streaming?
We can talk about that.
We can negotiate. And there are other people running as well.
In Camden Ward, there are 6 others. So there are 7 total candidates for 3 positions. Glen Eira has Camden Ward, Rosstown and Tucker. Each will vote up 3 councillors. We have 7 candidates. Mary Delahunty, Rebecca Pinskia, Joel Silva, Karen Herman, Dan Strait, Thomas Soonis, and myself.
And I'd like to mention Dan.
Dan Strait.
Because I was at Lenny's the other day and I saw his poster, which we're going to post because I've been going around the hood. We hang around the hood. Through the ghetto, and there are so many posters of you.
There are a few others too.
But there were a lot of you. But lately I've been noticing everybody else has been trying to catch up with you.
Yeah. Well, Joel was out there first and everyone was saying to me...
Yeah, who's this Joel Silva?
No, but everyone was saying to me, Ian, you better catch up. So then mine went up and then Karen's went up, then Dan's went up. So,
I've just seen some for Mary as well.
Yes.
So everyone's trying to catch the attention.
Well, it's brand awareness. You've got 35,000 people in Camden, 146 in Glen Eira total, 35, approximately 45% Jewish. And it's about brand awareness. The ballot papers have only just come out. So people need to see who they want to vote for. So there's a visual aspect. Mm-hmm. And then in the ballot papers that got sent out, we're doing postal votes by Glen Eira. Each candidate has a statement, a 200-word statement that's gone out from the Victorian Electoral Commission,
yep,
where people have a chance to read what each candidate wants to try to achieve and convince them to vote them number one. And that's what it's all about. Brand awareness.
I just got mine in the mail.
Exactly.
And I'm going to vote by post.
I can leave my how to vote card here for you, Henry.
Already got one. I found one somewhere in the gutter. I found one today in the post box. It was about to be blown. With all this wind we've been having,
yes, you're right.
Everything's just blowing
around.
Well,
one of my boards actually fell. The one on Balaclava Road fell down, had to be put back up through the wind.
Yeah, I know. And talking about blown away, I was at the AJAX Football Club awards night. Mm. And you invited me along just because I'm an ex-player and you're actually a famous ex-player.
Dual premiership. I keep gloating about it.
Yeah, I know. And your son came 3rd in the best and fairest.
He did.
And is the goal kicker of...
6 out of 7 years, the leading goal kicker.
David Fayman. He came 3rd on the night. And who came first? Brad Kaplan.
And the captain, Nick Marks, came 2nd.
That's right. What a beautiful bunch of guys you've got there.
It was wonderful.
Not to mention the jackets. Wow, what a spunky bunch of girls.
Wonderful.
Yes, I was there filming it. And completely to our surprise, we announced a new coach.
Yes, a very, very fantastic announcement. Mark Choco Williams, Premiership coach of Port Adelaide, I think 2004, and he's going to be coach of the senior club at AJAX.
Plus, and the juniors.
He's going to be the coach of the coaches of the juniors.
Yep.
He'll have a Maccabi role in basketball, netball. He'll be the coach of the coaches. He'll have 4,000 kids to look after.
He's actually a physical education teacher.
Yes, he was.
That's
correct.
What he is.
Yes, yes. And he's just been offloaded by Richmond and had a position. And we're very lucky to have got him. But congratulations to the current committee in securing his appointment.
Congratulations to Ronnie Lewis, particularly, and his crew.
Yes.
It's a coup.
It is a coup.
Absolutely. I think it's fantastic.
Yeah, for the community, having that sort of coach, a tremendous, tremendous.
Great sense of humour.
Lovely, lovely. Said a few funny things on Thursday night.
Fantastic attitude. I mean, he's tough.
I think he's got six kids or five or six kids. One of them at Caulfield Grammar. So he'll be in the community a lot. He'll be driving to Caulfield Glen Eira Road. He'll go past our community quite often.
And he's got a lot to learn about the Jewish community. He's never really had this kind of close...
Well, South Australian boy, small community. So, yes.
We're looking forward to that. And we'll do something on the AJAX Football Club at some stage before the next season. It's too late now. I mean, no one's thinking footy anymore.
Well, let's wait till they start. I think you'll start in January. After pre-season starts, maybe February, March, see how they're going. You can interview him.
Yeah, I'd
good.
Love to.
Yeah, it'd be good. It'd
be really great.
Henry, thanks. Thanks for giving me
Thank
the opportunity,
you,
and that'd be great. And hopefully the listeners will give me a chance.
I hope you've all had a good fast. How quick was that fast?
That went over so quickly. That was wonderful. Jeez, that was wonderful.
It was a really good fast this year. I wish you all Hag Sameach, because the Hagim continue.
It's a court afterwards.
And we'll be back with Lindy Tamir.
Ooh.
Yes. Who's
Israel, the film festival.
Yeah, the Jewish International Film Festival.
Wonderful.
Straight after the break.
I love this stick. I love